Good morning. This morning our scripture will be from Romans chapter 5. Isaiah 26. Isaiah chapter 26. In that day, this song will be sung in the land of Judah. We have a strong city. God makes salvation in its walls and ramparts. Open the gates that the righteous nation may enter, the nation that keeps faith. You will keep in perfect peace those whose minds are steadfast because they trust in you. Trust in the Lord forever, for the Lord Himself, is the rock eternal. He humbles those who dwell on high. He lays the lofty city low. He levels it to the ground and casts it down to the dust. Feet trample it down. The feet of the oppressed, the footsteps of the poor. The path of the righteous is level. You, the upright one, make the way of the righteous smooth. Yes, Lord, walking in the way of your laws, we wait for you. Your name and renown are the desire of our hearts. My soul yearns for you in the night. In the morning, my spirit longs for you. When your judgments come upon the earth, the people of the world learn righteousness. Beloved, Isaiah chapter 26 prophesies that a song will be sung in that day, which is the day of God's salvation. And the song is a song of praise and a song of joy. The coming of Jesus and his salvation is the fulfillment of this prophecy from Isaiah chapter 26. And the salvation comes to all who believe in him. As we noted in our previous devotion, in Christ we have been reconciled to God and are now at peace with him. In Christ we have been reconciled to God and are now at peace with him. But this reconciliation, this objective peace, leads to an internal peace. It is a peace, a calm, an inward tranquility believers have because they know they are in the family of God and the Heavenly Father is for them and not against them. It is this blessed fruit of the Holy Spirit that compelled Horatio Spafford to write the hymn, "It Is Well With My Soul," right after he has learned that his four daughters had been killed in a tragic accident. And this sense of peace, this shalom, also affects our relationships. The peaceful believer is inclined to be a peacemaker. The Apostle Paul tells us in Romans 12, verse 18, "If possible, as far as it depends on you, live peaceably with all." Our natural, sinful inclination can incline us to seek conflict and dwell on disagreements, but the Holy Spirit works in our minds and hearts to live peaceably with all. And this blessed fruit of the Spirit, this peace, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Paul's words to the Philippians. This is an inward, a calming peace that only the Holy Spirit can give. Let us now pray then for that inward, that calming peace that the Spirit gives. And let us ask for forgiveness for the weak faith that causes you and me to have anxiety and fear. Let us pray together. Our Heavenly Father, this morning we would like to thank you, give thanks for an inward calming peace that we may have. Thank you that your Spirit gifts us this calm every day, this peace. But Father, we still need to ask, pray for that inward calming peace. Holy Spirit, come and pour that out in us even more. As we are weak in faith, and we sometimes are full of anxiety and fear. Lord, hear us if we plead from you to forgive us for our weak faith. Thank you that in you we know our faith grows through the work of your Holy Spirit alone. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. This morning our song is All Over the World, The Spirit is Moving. For tomorrow morning, you can prepare Romans 8. We will be reading from Romans 8, verses 18 through 30, in our series on the work of the Holy Spirit in you. May you have a blessed day until 6:30 tomorrow morning. Goodbye.